Hey everyone, Ana Garcia here with Luis Bolaños. As you all know, Luis and I work on cases together. Luis is a former homicide detective, runs his own private investigation firm called Get Bit Investigations. And the reason we're here is because we asked you to help us with a 30-year-old cold case of a missing boy from New Jersey. We asked you to help, and you're helping. Right, Luis?
Absolutely. It's amazing. This tip I got yesterday is really concerning and would be the top of that number one stack.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so before Luis gets into the details of this tip, we're just going to remind everyone what this case is. In 1991, this week, the week of Thanksgiving, an 11-year-old boy in New Jersey was abducted. His name, Mark Himebaugh, red hair, freckles, blue eyes, just disappeared. Very few facts in this case, and we are determined that we're going to help break open this case. And the only way we can do it is with your help, because there's very little physical evidence. So let's start with something as simple as this. For 30 years, right, Luis, the cops have been telling us that they have no idea who this little girl is. So apparently, according to the police in Middle Township, New Jersey, this girl was seen with Mark on the afternoon that he disappeared, and the two of them were in a park nearby. Okay. Now we've been told for 30 years, we have no idea who she is. You get a tip and it looks like we have a potential ID on her.
Potential. And it's something that just cannot be ignored. And we're going to need your help, everybody's help, to try to pin this down. But I think it could actually be done. So I want to share a little bit. I got a call. It actually started out as an email, and it was so powerful that I called as an individual back as soon as I could. And what he told me was here, and I want to be as accurate as possible here. And so I'm going to look at the email he sent me back. He viewed the podcast that aired last week. He comes from Jersey, from New Jersey, right there in the villas. He lived right down the street from Mark Himebaugh. And he was there when this all happened.
So the amazing thing is that we asked all of you to help us, because there is no digital footprint, because there was no social media. So we want to build a digital footprint. Okay, so Luis, you get an email tip and then you follow up with a call. This is a guy who 10 years ago says he told the cops who this girl is, and nobody listened to him.
Right. He was a little bit frustrated because he said he made a couple phone calls to the police department. Never got a call back, was unable to leave the information. And the information that he wanted to leave was that about 10 years ago, he went to the FBI website because he was curious and wanted to read up on the status of this case, because he'd lived there. He lived down the street from Mark Himebaugh. He played with the same kids Mark did. But when he went to the website for the first time, he saw the sketch of this girl who allegedly was walking with Mark on the day that Mark was abducted. And it resonated with them immediately.
Yeah. There were in the sketch, right? This sketch is based on the memory of a park guard who remembered seeing this girl. And what was interesting is she was described as being like 9 or 10 years old. She was wearing a blue parka, a ski parka. And it was very unusual because it had this orange stripe on the back. And Luis, he told you that was key to remembering who she was.
Right. He said that sketch to him was spot on. It was a girl he used to play with, ride bikes with. All the kids played together in the neighborhood where Mark lived. And he remembered her first name only as Jess. Could be short for Jessica. But besides looking spot on with the sketch, the jacket that she was famous for as a kid and all the kids wanted because they loved her jacket was a jacket that was given to her by her dad, who was in the construction business and had orange stripes on it. He called it a hunter's stripe, or a construction stripe. So, and there's a few things that go up there that raise the flag higher and higher that just scream, we have to find this girl. He said he remembered her house, and she lived near the corner of Harvard Avenue and East Bates Avenue in the villas of New Jersey, which was right down the street from where Mark lived. And then there was a park right there. And shortly after he saw this sketch, he called law enforcement to pass the information on, never got a call back, became frustrated. And I've heard this scenario played out so many times in other cases where he just went on with his life. He just didn't think they valued or they give it in the merit it deserved, and they didn't want it, they didn't need it. But for whatever reason, that was it. Until he saw the podcast last week, the True Crime Daily podcast, highlighting Mark Himebaugh's story.
He wanted to make clear, is like, okay, so the police wouldn't listen to me when I called two times. So I'm going to call Lewis and I'm going to tell him the little bit that I know. But the little bit that he knows makes so much sense, especially because he says he remembers later on in life having a conversation with this girl named Jessica. And she said she remembered being in the park that day. So she admits she was in the park, and she said there was a really creepy guy. And that's why she left the park, because she also remembers the guy was wearing aviators and had long dark hair. All the pieces fit in. Okay, so Lewis, as a former cop, this is just a tiny little bit. How helpful is this information if we can figure out who Jessica is, if you all can help us figure out who this girl is?
Yeah, well, of course, the ultimate goal would be this leads to what happened that day to Mark. That's the ultimate goal. You know, it's the type of tip that you just have to follow up, and you have to close the loop on it. You can't ignore it. So I think that if we get this girl identified, it could answer some questions that may lead to further this investigation. She's important because she was with Mark allegedly after the fire, when he walked back into town, right? And if you go with the theory that Mark lost his shoe, he would have been walking with her barefooted. Maybe all that is explained.
Maybe he didn't lose his shoe, right? And maybe she remembers he had his sneakers on. But the bottom line is that the police have said for 30 years they have no idea who this is. And what we're saying is we have a potential tipster here who can help identify her and narrow this down. Okay, he says that this girl went to Sandman Elementary School. So somewhere between 1990 and 93, someone's got to have a school yearbook, school records. If you went to this school in Lower Township, New Jersey, then maybe you remember this girl who maybe is named Jessica. And I'm sorry, this is a really crappy copy, but I have a crappy printer, you know, but the whole point is, if we can just eliminate this one piece of the puzzle, then we can move on. And then maybe we take these pieces and put them together and have a better idea of what happened to Mark Himebaugh. So how can people get in touch with you, Lewis? Because sometimes they feel more comfortable talking to you than the police.
Yeah, sometimes they do. My social media footprint is getbitinvestigations.com. My phone number's on there. My email's on there. Easy to get a hold of me, right? I will respond.
So everyone, please help us out. It's Thanksgiving week. This is the week that Mark disappeared. The Himebaugh family, they are still waiting for answers. We need your help to solve this case.